Hey folks, it's Jang here with a couple of new LEGO system train related MOCs. I've got just a general utility truck here, and then I have a track geometry vehicle, which is highly specialized. So I'll move this one off to the side and just focus on one at a time. First off, this is just based on a standard American pickup truck with a long bed, and it's just for general work use. I stuck with the four lug wide width for this, for the chassis and the body, because that's the scale that I want to use for my particular city. And then I'm going with kind of the utility color scheme for one of the train companies that I'm going to have on my layout. The first train, full train mock that I did is the first high-speed passenger train, pair of locomotives end-to-end that use a white and orange color scheme. But then I came up with my diesel switcher, which uses, actually I have it here, uses the gray, dark gray and orange color scheme instead. So that's going to be more of the freight side, and the utility and maintenance side is what I hope. And you can look up what set that I got that one from. But inspiration for this one, I was looking at a couple of other actual official city sets of trucks, or that have trucks in them, and they both had six wide sizes. It was just way too big for the scale that I want to use. So I went ahead and kind of followed their general look, but scaled it down to four, the width of four. So I've got, you know, a couple of compartments on the sides. You can open these up. I just realized now in this light, you can see that that's an old gray piece. So I'll have to change that out. But a couple of compartments, haven't put anything in there. Opening doors. I got my little guy inside of there. It was a driver. He's fitting in. And then tools on the side. You got a shovel here, pickaxe on this side. You know, normal stuff that you would use for maintenance of roads and asphalt, concrete, junctions and stuff. So, and then this back actually opens up, and I can see another old gray piece there. I need to go through and make sure that I don't have too many of those, but this opens up just for the sake of it. I just wanted to have, mostly for the look, not of having it down, but just when it's up. And then inside I put a little tamper, a little gas-powered tamper, which is a compacting device. You know, a minifig would hold it back here, turn it on, up the throttle, and it just does like that. You know, it's for tamping down gravel and asphalt in small areas, and also dirt to some degree, but mostly rocky stuff, just to get compaction on the top in a very small area. So I wanted to have something back there that it would actually carry, that was actually large, you know, not just a small tool. So I added that in, and it does the trick. It fits in and takes up some space and makes it look like it has more purpose. And yeah, there you go. Takes care of that one. And got lights on there. And like I said, the color scheme works out. Happy with that. And then the second one, like I said, is a track geometry vehicle, also a track inspection vehicle. So for this one, this is not inspired by anything that actually exists as far as its design. I mean, there are actual track geometry vehicles. Some of them are train-based, where they're actually train cars that are highly specialized and made just for one purpose, and then others are truck-based. This is intended to be a fully coach-built one, so it's not based on any existing production truck that's on the market. There we go. I'm just going to show you how this works with an actual little bit of train rail. These have the ability to, so assuming that it's one designed for road use, you can move this down, and now you've got rail there. You can move this down, you've got rail there. And then finally, you take this whole thing, and this goes down onto the rails as well. And this is a sensor array. So what happens in real life with these things is that they put all sorts of different small wheels down, angled in different ways with position and pressure sensors on them. And this thing just drives slowly over tracks, and it has basically fixed locations of these wheels here in a very rigid frame. So any motion that as this thing, you know, goes over bumps in the rails and banking and turns and stuff, these sensors can record exactly what's going on. So these give you a three-dimensional picture of the shape of the rails, of the entire line. So they're essential for maintaining railways and seeing how they shift over time, if the bed is shifting, if you've got kind of a sinkhole area going on, stuff you can't easily visibly see. These will record, and they'll just give a printout at the end, or just tons and tons of numerical data that can be used to locate areas of track that need to be repaired or reinforced. So that's what I've done here, and I don't know what those things actually look like on the top, and I don't think I've seen any that are actually open like this, but hey, it doesn't have to be a replica of a real thing, thankfully, for Lego. So I've just created a truck that's kind of almost like a really short mobile home or motor home. And it's got a single driver in there. And then it also has a compartment in the back. So this was important for me. I made it just long enough. I didn't want to make a big old thing. I made it just long enough. And this is an old piece up here, old sunroof piece, opens up. I was happy to be able to use the trans dark blue. And there's a guy in there, and he is monitoring the situation and the information that's coming from the sensors. So in case they see something that's really bad that may warrant stopping the railway and shutting down the railway immediately, he's looking at the data in real time and also seeing if maybe the sensors have gone off track a little bit. They're giving consistently wacky readings. So he's got a computer screen and another is probably an oscilloscope or something that's hooked up that's showing various information along the way. And there's enough, as you can see, there's enough room for him to actually sit in there, and he gets a little bit of light, so you can kind of see him from the outside, kind of, yeah. See him a little bit, there he is, that's his face. That was pretty fun, getting two guys in there. And yeah, countless revisions to get this thing to actually work out, but I'm happy with the end result. Actually, this can open up too, maybe it'll be a better look. Or does it? Wait a minute. Not that familiar with that piece, to be honest. That does open up. So maybe I should just leave that open a little bit, like so. Yeah, that's even better. So now it's giving him some ventilation, and you can really see the action that thing is capable of. And then I can just put this up, like so, and then pull these rail wheels up in the front and in the back, and it transitions to use on regular roads. Just fine. So there you go. A couple of new things for my railway to be, for my unnamed rail related company. What you see is what you get. I'll be doing more stuff like this, not just train related, of course, but stuff will be coming up. So follow along with updates and where I'm at by following the blog. LegoJang.com is a shortcut URL to get you right there, and make sure you're subscribed if you want to see more stuff from me on YouTube, LegoJang.com. YouTube.com/LegoJang. There we go. Okay, bye for now.